Though there's talk that Kyler Yamamoto or Jesse Puljujarvi could be traded this summer, we can say for certain that both players along with Ryan McLeod will be issued qualifying offers by the Edmonton Oilers. Those are Edmonton's main three restricted free agents, but what about the other ones? Two of the Oilers' RFAs, defender Philip Berglund and winger Ostap Safin, have already signed deals overseas, so Ken Holland and co. will have decisions to make on two other forwards. Brendan Perlini and Tyler Benson are forwards with draft pedigree and impressive AHL numbers who have yet to figure it out at the NHL level. Will they be back? The Lamborghini got a lot of hype in training camp as Perlini scored 5 goals in 5 preseason games, but much like with Ty Ratty and others in the past, the performance didn't translate into the regular season. Perlini scored 4 goals over 23 games, and the most memorable part of his season was when his mom tweeted about breaking the news to him that he'd been placed on waivers. Perlini did well with the Bakersfield Condors as he scored 11 goals and 18 points in 18 games, but he didn't get another look with the big league club. Given his draft pedigree as a former number 12 overall pick, somebody will more than likely give Perlini a look in the NHL next season, and it wouldn't be a mistake for the Oilers to bring him back as a depth player. But there are names like this floating around in free agency each summer, and it wouldn't be surprising for the Oilers to let Perlini go and take a flyer on somebody else. The Oilers made a controversial decision with the number 32 overall pick in the 2016 draft. Rather than going with goaltender Carter Hart, who would have fit an organizational need, or winger Alex DeBrincat, who thrived playing alongside Connor McDavid in the OHL, the Oilers opted to select Tyler Benson, a local prodigy who set the Alberta Bantam AAA scoring record a few years earlier. The problems with Benson on his draft day are the same problems that are holding him back from becoming a regular NHL player 6 years later. While he boasts incredible vision and playmaking talent, Benson doesn't have the skating ability to keep up with a fast-paced game at the NHL level. Benson cracked the Oilers out of training camp due in part to him being waiver eligible. He came in and out of the lineup, was seldom used outside of a fourth line role, and scored 1 goal and 1 assist over 29 games before being placed on waivers in March. Last summer was the end of Benson's entry-level deal, and he came back on a 1-year deal worth $750,000. He's again a restricted free agent, and it's difficult to say if the Oilers are willing to commit another year to seeing if Benson can find a role in the NHL. Beyond where he might fit on an NHL roster, the Bakersfield Condors might also be too loaded up front for Benson to come back. AHL veterans James Hamblin, Luke Esposito, Seth Griffith, and Brad Malone are already in the mix. Raphael Lavoie will be looking for a larger role, and the team will see an influx of young talent as Carter Savoie, Tyler Tulio, Xavier Bourglot, and possibly Matt V. Petrov will be turning pro. Tyler Benson has proved everything he can in the AHL, and if the Oilers aren't interested in giving him a look as an NHLer, they're best just cutting ties and giving him a chance to catch on with another organization.